The question is, for a new MLA like I am, is how do you be an MLA? And one of the jobs of a member of the legislature is to be a representative of the people in his or her riding. So it means it's important to be in touch on a regular basis with people in the riding, and that's why I'm having regular neighborhood meetings to do just that. That way, I know what's on the mind of my constituents, and they can hear what's going on at the legislature and give some feedback. Also, I need to think about how to be an MLA for young people, and so I'll be looking at how to be in the schools and how to be on campus as their MLA, because their voices are really important, need to be heard too. The first neighborhood meeting was here in Skyline Acres, and it was a special one in a sense because we really had a project focus. And the idea came out of the great gathering in Fredericton, which was how do we build community, how do we build some focal point in our neighborhoods around the city, recognizing that in many neighborhoods that doesn't really exist in a major way. So I was successful in applying to have three social work students as interns to do their social action placement with me as MLA in Fredericton South here.
My name is Jess McCauley.
I'm Adrienne Kasdan.
And Samantha Silver.
And so they began the process of looking at what kind of assets there are in the neighborhood, Skyline Acres, Forest Hill, meeting with the principals, the ministers at the churches, the folks over at the fire hall, the staff at the Boys and Girls Club, and so on.
We drove around the neighborhood, the Skyline Acres neighborhood. We had to define the boundaries of the neighborhood, which is a little bit difficult because one neighborhood doesn't exactly end where the next begins. But we drove around all the streets and just took a look at what we thought the assets already were. So we got to know where the different organizations were, where are the schools, where are all the parks, where are the trails, do they have pools, do they have lots of trees, what kind of housing is there, is it apartments, is it subsidized housing, is it single family homes. So first we just tried to get a sense of what the fabric of that neighborhood was. We mapped it all out on a real map. And then we started just dropping in to all the places that we thought might have contact people who would be maybe community leaders. So in dropping in, we would introduce ourselves and say that we're working on, you know, a community building project with David. And we started scheduling interviews so that we could meet with all of these community leaders again and find out what programs and services they offer, what they know about the neighborhood, what kind of sense of community they feel.
And then the Boys and Girls Club offered the building, the hall there, as a venue for our neighborhood meeting. So the students put together a flyer and delivered the flyer to all the mailboxes in the neighborhood, inviting people to my first neighborhood meeting.
Your arms around me and I'm home.
So we were so scared at first because, I mean, normally when you plan an event, I think you might already know the group who you're bringing together. You might have some means of calculating your potential numbers, and we really had no idea. We put out just under 2,000 flyers, and we had absolutely no way of estimating how many people would come. And of course, the Boys and Girls Club, which is the venue we used, had a maximum capacity. So we were kind of worried. We had no idea. Oh my goodness, are we going to go over maximum capacity? Is nobody going to show up?
Yeah.
We had probably about 10 tables set up, and we had about 6 to 8 people sitting at one table together. And at those tables, they had lots of markers and paper and lots of stuff that they could doodle and write down their like brainstorming ideas. Dennis was the facilitator, so he has a lot of experience, which was just amazing because he brings an energy to what he does.
Can we all form a circle in the space that's involved here, and we'll begin? So communities have met in a circle for a long time, but for some of us, this might be a bit of a new exercise, especially connecting it to the political process as it connects to city council and to the provincial legislature. So how exciting do you think that ideas that you generate today amongst your cumulative heart power and brain power through a World Cafe will make its way to city council chambers and make its way to the floor of the legislature? So that's awesome, and I wanted to make sure you noted that. Community self-organization, community conversation, turning into change for what you want for your community. And we do that together in a circle. But to start is part of the heart of this whole thing. Take a moment and think of a word, a movement, or a song title that reflects how you feel right now. And we're going to go around, and everybody just a quick bump. A word, a movement, or a song title.
Anticipation.
Reveal the first question, they would answer the first question in small groups, and then we would go into what we call the popcorn session. And so after about 15 minutes of the small group activity, one representative from each of the tables would share the ideas to the larger group.
Do people feel that this is a safe neighborhood?
Dog friendly.
Is somewhat self-sufficient?
Walking paths.
We have a few stores.
Established, mature neighborhood.
It's quite walkable.
And then they would go and take their written ideas, their sheet of written ideas, and attach it to the question that was up on the wall. So it was like a physical and visual thing. So it was up. We kind of made a mural of the questions and all the answers that everybody gave, all kind of pasted onto it. So after that session, one person at each table would stay at the table and everyone else would at random get up and go sit elsewhere, so that during the 3 rounds, everyone was working in a different small group, and that way people can make more little connections with each other.
3 questions. So the first question was,
what is great about living in the Skyline Acres neighborhood. So we wanted to focus like first on a strength, like what's already existing here and what's working well, what do people love about the neighborhood? And the ideas just came and came. And then the second question focused on, I guess, like areas of growth. So what would you like to see change in the neighborhood in 4 years or happen or something?
Yeah, I was worried what could make it better.
What could make it better in the next 4 years?
So again, a positive.
Yeah.
A positive way of wording that question.
Yeah, exactly. And that, like, for the areas of growth, like, it was really great to hear that because we knew there were going to be needs, but this type of event, or I guess this type of activity, it kind of brings it in, like, for aspirations for people, so it comes, it's really positive, so people, like, what they want to see, so it's not, I guess it stays away from that negativity or people complaining all the time, but it's still the exact same. It's productive, and it's the exact same things that would come out of any other meeting that was more of a needs-based.
Yeah.
And then the third question was, how can we make this happen? So it's more of an action question, and that was the one that kind of stemmed ideas about people creating a residence association or potlucks, barbecues.
It was great just to see people eating and mingling, and some people, like, you were just meeting for the first time, but you were having great conversation, and there was a guy going around with a petition and asking people to sign it, so seeing those relationships start to grow and develop was really, really quite great.
At the very end, just the feeling was that I think it had to do with the wording of the questions being so positive and bringing up all these strengths. There's just this feeling of positivity that everybody had created or been participated in a creative process rather than a kind of combative. We often think of political processes as being combative and hierarchical, but this was a really creative and very positive process. So that was my favorite. It was just a sense at the end. It wasn't like a concrete moment, but we had many participants say to us, oh, that was so positive. Like, with a kind of surprise in their voices, so.
There was, like, the two themes that were brought forth were, like, community building types of events, and then social action, social political, and, like, wider issues, and organizing for action around that. I really hope to see these meetings continue over time, because it really is the true democratic process, and we should be getting involved and participating in it like this, so that we can all work together to bring, well, make our communities better and more connected.
So that's the thinking about the beginning of how to become an MLA and carry out my responsibility as a representative of the constituents, to represent the constituents in the Legislative Assembly. There, of course, are two other important functions. One is as a lawmaker or a legislator, working on laws, on bills in the legislature. And then, of course, as a watchdog, that is to kind of examine and be a watchdog over how public money is spent by the government of the day. So those are the three major parts of an MLA's job. And certainly one of the most enjoyable so far is meeting with the constituents in the neighborhood, talking about what they love about their community and how we can improve it and how we might go about doing that.